Hey guys, what's up? This is Sean from 404 Average Automotive, and today we have a 2020 Lamborghini Urus, thanks to Mueller's Mazda and Volvo here in Lubbock, Texas.
Look. It could be worse. Used to be scared of the first. I used to pack at the merch, go do the show. Had to put square on my phone. I used to pray that it work, ain't always work. I used to play at the church. That it ain't coming no perks. A was the verse. Come to me all over thirsty. Got living water for sure. Mine was a nurse. Had a whole life in the purse. Might get a face on the shirt. Hank on the waiter, right to the table. She asked me what do I want for dessert. I told her surprise me. Ain't much surprise me, man. All of my heels be wildin', man. Look at what happened to Cosby, man. Look at what happened to Robbie, damn. Trying to make sure that it's not me, man. Whole life been knocking me, man. I'ma run when temptation come, it got me, man. But hey, it could be worse. It could be worse. Life is hard.
On this Lamborghini Urus, it is in this beautiful Lamborghini yellow color that's a factory color. The thing about the Urus is it's very pointed. So everything comes to a point everywhere on this car, which is kind of crazy. It has a very unique grille on these. I've seen a lot of people online say these look like the March Madness brackets, which is kind of crazy. It has a very unique Lamborghini headlight style, which if you look, it's in the shape of a Y. Those Ys in the headlight, like in the crystals and stuff, which is really cool. And you'll see that that kind of follows all over the car. So if you want to come to the side of the Urus, this has fat freaking tires and rims. It has carbon ceramic brakes. The really cool thing about these tires, though, is they're made specifically for this Urus, and it has a Lamborghini L on the tire. Those are probably really, really expensive. It has matching brake calipers to the paint, which is really cool to see Lamborghini on them. It has a very aggressive side end that, I mean, you know what this is when you drive next to it. It has a kind of weird looking fake vent thing here with the Italian flag, which is cool because this is an Italian car. It's black on yellow, which is really nice. When you come to the back of the car, you have a very unique back end. That Y thing follows right here, where you have the Y going on the tail lights, you have the Y in the crystals like we talked about. The reverse lights are these tiny, tiny, tiny lights right here, which is really freaking weird. The other really weird thing that's unique to this car is you don't have a windshield wiper on this back window. Why it's that way is because it's so slanted, Lamborghini thought any water that gets on this is just gonna fly right off the back when you're driving. So that's something you would only see in the Urus. All other SUVs come with a little windshield wiper of some form to do this, but they have such a big slant on this window that it's just gonna fall right off. So it's pretty cool. It's a very unique car. It's a really surreal car, and it's very sinister looking. Now let's go to the trunk of the Urus. So in the trunk, I'm gonna open it up. Automatic, which is really cool. It has a really, really cool, unique trunk. I like this chrome piece right here. Usually this is just some cheap plastic when you get a Honda, Toyota, Infiniti, whatever you wanna call it. You have a protector right here that matches the seat. So it's that black with the yellow stitching, even though this is plastic, but it looks like leather, which is really nice. You can control the ride height right here, which is really cool. So when you press that, the car will lower and heighten itself, if that's a word, to whatever you need. In the UK specs, which is really unique that I saw online, is these blank buttons right here is how you retract the trailer hitch. So there's a trailer hitch hidden down there, and then you press these buttons and it'll pop out, which is really, really cool. So all together, it's a really cool trunk. It's really spacious. You get this like Lamborghini bag that has all the stuff you need in it. I'm kind of curious if it's got the white gloves. Nope, it's a tricker charger. It does not have the white gloves. It's infamous for Lamborghinis, but it's pretty cool. Another really cool thing about the trunk is, I'm gonna find a key. That's my key. Hold up. When you close it, it sounds like a truck backing up. It slowly fades away into the sunset, baby. On the inside of the Urus, it's a super, super nice interior. It looks very sporty, but this is also a sport SUV that's made for family. I would say this is probably one of the nicest interiors I've been in with the cars I've done on this channel, but it is just beautiful and they have attention to detail. That whole Y-shaped thing that I talked about on the outside, they're also on these speakers and on the speakers down below next to your feet, which is kind of cool. But on the inside, they have more of a hexagon thing going on. So if you look, the air vents are hexagon, the stitching in the seat is a hexagon, the cup holder is hexagon, the buttons next to the cup holder is hexagon, all the buttons on the screen that are touchscreen are hexagons, And then you got a hexagon on the steering wheel. There's just so many hexagons on the inside. But I also feel like that ties with the Y thing. It was just trying to make it flow. And they did very well with it. It has yellow stitching. They're black seats. I really like these headrests that have the yellow Lamborghini badge on top of it. This is a very, very nice steering wheel. It has very, very good feeling paddle shifters. You got the Italian flag on the steering wheel, much like the side of the car. You got like this kind of black plastic looking thing on the dash, which is kind of cool. I mean, it flows with it, it looks really nice. And then you got this ginormous double touch screen, heads up display, center console, whatever you want to call that. And through this, you control the AC down below, and then up top is your GPS radio and all that, so it's pretty cool. It has a very, very unique gear shift system, I guess you want to say. When I did the Huracan, all you really had, you didn't have these screens at all, you just had this button, which puts you in whatever drive mode you want to be in, and then you had the paddle, so there's no screens right here. And how you put this in drive is you hit this paddle, and that goes to first gear. When you hit both paddles, it puts you in neutral. When you pull this back, so when you like do that kind of thing, now I'm in reverse. So it's kind of crazy. It also has that fighter jet where you kind of flip that up and you can start and stop it, because Lamborghini, like I said in the Huracan video, is going for a fighter jet vibe. This has so many more driving options than the Huracan did, because the Huracan just had Strada, Sport, and Corso. This has three other ones that are Italian words that I don't know what they mean. I'm sure it's off-roading stuff or something, but it has a total of six driving modes on this one, which is pretty cool. They also have, on the right side, Ego mode, which means you can custom make and do all your own settings to whatever pleases you. So that's pretty cool. It has super nice pedals down here, and it's just, it is a beautiful freaking car. I love this thing. I think it's the perfect spec, and it got my stamp of approval for sure. In the back seat of the Urus, it is the same seat design as the front seat, where you got the black with the yellow stitching, which is really cool. But something I really like is the Alcantara on the roof. You got a fully panoramic moon roof over here. It's kind of comfortable back here, but it kind of honestly feels like the back seat of a sports car, because there's not very much room, but it's all good. You get a view of the really cool racing seats they have up front. You have your basic AC controls. You have your cup holders and stuff over here, which is really cool. And I mean, that's pretty much it here. But there's a few things I missed up front that I want to bring up. And one of them is, when you turn off your car, but you're in accessory mode, you can drain your battery. Where Lamborghini thought about that, and when you turn off the car, if the accessories are still on, the door handles will light up red till you turn off the accessory mode to let you know that you left them on, which is pretty cool. Another really cool thing I like to talk about back here is the key is beautiful. It has that point like it does at the front of the car, kind of almost looks like that. It has a Lamborghini badge. It says Lamborghini on the back, and you have the unlock, lock, and trunk button, and that's about it. So it's pretty cool, but it's a really nice back seat. There's not room for activities, sadly, back here, but besides that, it's pretty solid. On the engine of this Lamborghini, it has a 5-liter V8, this twin turbo, and this is pushing about 640 horsepower. I couldn't find the 0 to 60 or 0 to 100 or quarter mile times on this, because whenever I looked up the Urus stats, it always came up with Performante stuff besides that. So not much to say on the engine, but it she's a beast. Let's see how it sounds. Fact I just found out while doing B-roll is, whenever you change the driving mode, it changes the entire heads-up display. So I got B-roll of that we're running right now. Thanks for watching. Like, share, subscribe, follow us on Facebook, Instagram, TikTok, YouTube, and Twitter. Special thanks to Mears Rover and Mazda here in Lubbock, Texas for letting us do another one of these high-end cars. They were dream cars to most people. I'm very grateful for their support of this channel. If you guys are interested in buying this car, you can contact Mears Rover here in Lubbock, Texas. Say Sean sent you. Besides that, I mean, we'll see you guys next week. I hope you have a good week.